story this week is, all right, many of you may know that heard on the news that rapper Juice WRLD, the rapper who sung that song, that hit right here.
I still see your shadows in my room. Can't take back the love that I gave you. It's to the point why I love and I hate you. And I cannot change you, so I must replace you. Oh, easier said than done. I thought you were the one listening to my heart instead of my head. You found another one, but I am the better one. I won't let you forget me.
Yeah, he has died at the age of 21. Wow, a young age. He has so much to give to the world and so much. But then there's also controversy surrounding him about drug paraphernalia at the Chicago airport where he had was pronounced dead. Ooh, my God. But many of you, let's get to a backstory. Many of you might not be aware who he is with this.
I think you're helping lead in the change of teaching young people how to deal with their feelings.
Mm-hmm.
How does it feel to say that you could lead that charge or be a leader in that charge?
I mean, it feels great. It's a blessing. And honestly, somebody got to do it. That's part of being honest, telling people how you feel, not beating around the bush. You can miss your opportunity not expressing yourself. It's okay to express the way you feel. Nobody's going to shove you in a locker for that.
First of all, thank you for having us out here, man.
Course,
out here in Chicago, you know, just being a hip hop head. There's so much history here. There's so much great energy here.
Yeah.
How'd your hometown affect you?
It affected me in a lot of ways. You said you're from Brooklyn. People from Brooklyn, they have a certain swag. They have a certain charisma about them. I'm from Chicago. I have a different swag, different set of mannerisms, different style. You know what I'm saying? But it gives you originality.
All right, you finally caught up with how the rapper was, you know, telling us backstory of his background and stuff, and now we just found out he died. Because I heard his song so many times on the radio constantly. I said, oh, that's that dude. You know, when the song like, dun, dun. So, wow. And let's hear what YouTuber Layla Lynn has to say on this whole investigation surrounding Juice WRLD's death. Watch this.
Information regarding Juice WRLD's last moments from the sister of one of the guys that was on the jet with Juice WRLD when it was raided by the FBI and the FAA. Yesterday, TMZ reported, quote, "We were told at some point between the plane landing and the feds conducting their search, Juice was seen swallowing several Percocet pills in what people believe was an attempt to hide them. So she's provided me some exclusive information regarding whether or not Juice was seen swallowing the Percocet pills as being reported in the media. According to reports, the FBI seized 70 pounds of weed, 6 bottles of lean, and Juice WRLD allegedly swallowed several Percocet pills to avoid them being seized. Now, again, according to reports like TMZ, they're saying that Juice WRLD was seen swallowing the pills, but she actually sent me a DM on Instagram and explained that he was not seen taking the pills. She says, my youngest brother was one of the men arrested, whom is now out. And she goes on to say, when everyone on the plane realized the feds were waiting, Juice went to the bathroom alone. He said he was going to flush them, but once he got in there, he must have had a change of heart or realized that he couldn't. And she goes on to say, the fact that it was his idea to swallow them in a split second decision after he got into the bathroom is an important fact. So I'm assuming this is what her brother told her, that they didn't actually see him and watch him swallow the Percocet pills. He allegedly actually went into the bathroom alone and they didn't actually see him swallow the pills. Now, I saw a lot of you guys ask, why was Juice so concerned about the Percocet pills when there were 70 pounds of weed on the plane that couldn't be hidden? 70 pounds. And based on new information that's been released today, it appears that this wasn't the first time that the feds and the FAA had targeted Juice. TMZ reports, Juice's initial run-in with the feds went down on November 18th at LAX. The rapper and his entourage were boarding their flight bound for Sydney, Australia when customs agents conducted the search. Drug-sniffing dogs were all over Juice and his entourage and their luggage, but it's unclear if agents found anything, and the plane was eventually allowed to take off with Juice on board. So it sounds like, this is my opinion, it sounds like Juice may have panicked because this wasn't the first time that feds had raided his plane. This wasn't the first time, it was the second time, according to reports, and that may have been what caused him to panic and swallow the
All right, you saw right there, Leia Lynn giving you the 411 on Juice WRLD's death. It's sad to see a young man, 21 years old, didn't even see the world. But, you know, let's, you know, pray for him, his fans, his family, and everyone involved. And his music will live on. I know it will. All right, in other